independent dog handler Stuart Phillips and his partners Yo-Yo and Scamp are teaming up with Newcastle Trading Standards to disrupt a dangerous black market. Up and down the UK, under the counters of humble corner shops, organised crime gangs are flooding our streets with illegally smuggled tobacco.
Most people think it's not harmful, it's just cheap cigarettes. Unfortunately, illegal tobacco is connected to organised crime, people trafficking. It's connected to child sexual exploitation. It's connected to drugs, firearms. It's a huge problem.
Taking on the task are Stuart's top tobacco detection dogs.
Right, Yoey, up here. Up. Right, sit. This is Yo-Yo. He's 5-year-old Cocker Spaniel. And this is Scamp, who's he's about 6 now, and he's an English Springer Spaniel.
Their breed types are gun dogs. They're meant to be working. When they're not working, their pets being pampered.
Being cared for is something quite new to Yo-Yo. He was a rescue puppy.
When I took him on, we didn't think that he'd be up to much, to be honest. He was really underweight, and being kept in a cage and not being treated very well. He was very timid, scared of his own shadow. We rescued him to have him as a pet, but after having him home for 5-6 months, his confidence came back, and he has really turned into a phenomenal dog.
Today, the team are planning to raid 3 different shops, all suspected to be selling illegal cigarettes.
We're going to do Yo-Yo in first. Give him a go. Good boy.
If Yo-Yo can find the illegal tobacco, he'll take money out of the pockets of organised crime gangs.
Yo-Yo.
Sometimes the dog leads, or sometimes I lead. There's no set pattern, really.
Yo-Yo, what's this?
It's a bit like a comedy act sometimes, me and the dogs.
So far, Stuart and Yo-Yo haven't found anything.
Yo-Yo, where's that dog?
He's very, very chaotic, and there's no method in his searching. He's all over the place, very much like me, I think.
Yo-Yo, what's this? Yo-Yo, come.
I was a bit surprised when Yo-Yo didn't find something.
Nothing here.
The intelligence was it was being sold from that shop.
Knowing how important it is to disrupt this criminal enterprise, Stuart turns to his trusty tobacco detection dog, Scamp. But will this seasoned spaniel pick up the scent?
One of the reasons that we use dogs is because they're more accurate, they're quicker, and they're more reliable at searching than human officers, and Scamp is very quick. You can search your premises very quickly with him and establish whether there is something there or not.
It's not long before he's picked up the scent. But Scamp's got to wait for his partner, Stuart, to catch up.
I didn't need that shell. Dog's indicating here. Good boy, Scampy.
Sometimes I think he knows he's quite good.
A really good find there. Probably about half a day's worth there. They would probably be topped up about lunchtime-ish again. So, yeah, that's a good stash. Yeah, you should have got that. He's been wandering around in here.
From now on, Trading Standards will be keeping tabs on this corner shop.
We wouldn't have ever seen it unless we were crawling around on the floor, lifting every single shelf up, but the dog identified it fairly sharpish and it's pulled out a decent little haul for us.
But Stuart's left wondering what happened to Yo-Yo earlier.
The dogs do have up and down days. Yo-Yo, I think everything is just a big game to him, getting a bit concerned.
With 2 more raids planned for today, Stuart needs Yo-Yo to get serious.
We've had some fresh intelligence regarding this premises. Fingers crossed we should get some kind of seizure here. I was up here last week and we actually visited this shop. A gentleman from the shop, he ran off. I started chasing him and I had to give the dog to someone else, and but unfortunately I lost him. He was a lot younger and fitter than me.
Stuart's not going to let this suspected illegal tobacco trader get away from him again. And so, after Yo-Yo's earlier miss, he's relying on old hand Scamp.
He's on top form. You're on top form, Scamp, aren't you?
While police make their way to the front of the shop, Scamp and Stuart get into position.
Get him, he's the one. That's him, that's him.
That's
him, in here, mate.
Why, for what? Why is it?
He's the runner from last time. That's the one from last time, with a bag. He tried to get out the back.
With Scamp's help this time, Stuart's got his man. But to secure a conviction, they must now find the illegal tobacco.
A genuine packet of cigarettes will be about £10. And the products that we're looking for, you know, a pack of smuggled cigarettes or a packet of even fake cigarettes, is going to be £2 or £3. Pocket money prices sold to kids.
So far, Scamp's indicating the store is clean. It looks like Stuart's runner might get away from him again. While Scamp continues searching the shop, the police search the man who tried to run away.
I just put what you've got on here. What's this talking for?
This one, I find it.
You found it?
I found it in the street. I keep it in my pocket. Sometimes I find things, I keep it, you know, in my pocket.
The people that sell illegal tobacco are constantly developing the ways in which they hide or conceal tobacco. Another new tactic that they use to try and avoid any type of prosecution, they will keep the illegal tobacco in cars or vans.
Even though they have a key, the police can't just open the vehicle and start searching. They need Scamp to tell them there's tobacco inside.
Yes! Bingo. Good boy, Scampy! Good boy!
Using just his nose, Scamp has uncovered a huge £900 worth of illegal cigarettes.
Scamp came up trumps again.
And thanks to Scamp, Stuart's reputation is restored. But with only one more raid today, will Yo-Yo be able to redeem himself?
Good boy, Yo-Yo!
He can be a bit temperamental. Yeah, he's a very good dog. I was quite keen for him to have a find.
Yo-y, this way. Yo-yo. Yo-y, come. And nothing here at the moment. What's this?
This time, Yo-yo's having no trouble.
Yo-yo's indicating here. Yo-yo. It's a really nice find, that.
He's a funny little dog, but I like that. That's part of his character. And he gets the job done at the end of the day.
In just one day, Stuart, Yo-Yo and Scamp have helped seize a huge £2,500 worth of illegal tobacco.
I'm happy for myself, I'm happy for Trading Standards or whoever I'm working for, but I'm happy for the dog, because the dog is doing what he is trained to do. The dog's doing what he's happiest doing, and he's going to get some playtime.
Come on, then.